Do you want to host your website or static files on your domain using a VPS on Amazon AWS service that do for free for 1 year, so when Zaid is here, you don't need to go anywhere? So to host our static files to our domain, we are going to use Amazon's AWS service. So first of all, you will need to go to Google Chrome and type in aws.amazon.com and just sign in to the console. I'm hoping that you all have an AWS account already. So as I have an AWS account, I'll sign in. Alright, so now what you need to do is you need to go into launch a virtual machine. Just click there, launch a virtual machine. It will redirect you to us.east2.console.aws.amazon.com. It's such a huge URL, but so first of all, you need to select in from here, you need to select Ubuntu Server 20. So just select that, and then from here, you need to select the T2 Micro, which is free for 1 year. So for the first 12 months, it will be free, and it is having a memory of 1 GB and storage of around 8 GB. Just review and launch, put it like this, and from here you need to select create a new key pair, and you have to name it as whatever you want. So what is this key pair? I'll tell you what it is. So first give any name like my key pair and just download that .pem. So launch instances, just close this, and your instances are now launching. Just view your instances, and there our instance is running. So first of all, now to connect to it, we'll use SSH. So now what is this SSH? So first of all, if you are on a Windows machine, just go to PowerShell. So PowerShell, and if you are on a Mac or a Linux PC, then you need to go to terminal. Just search in for terminal and you'll get it there. So for in Windows laptop, as I'm in a Windows laptop, I need to go to PowerShell. So just go there and go to download CD downloads. Now I'm in the downloads directory, which is having a lot of files. The command which I use is cd, which means change directory, and to the directory or the path of the folder which you want to go inside. And after that, I do ls, which means list all the files inside that directory. So now what we need to do is we need to use the ssh command. So just write that ssh -i, and what did we name the file as? The PEM file which we named as was mykeypair.pem. So just copy that. So just write that mykeypair.pem, and then we need to write that Ubuntu @ and the public IPv4 address. Paste it in there and press enter. So it will ask you a question. So what you need to do is just write the yes and press enter, and there you are connected to your virtual machine. So just write the clear, clear, which will clear out the terminal for you. The third step is to install Nginx. So now what is this Nginx? So by default, if you make a request to our server, it goes on port 80, but we want to run another serve in another file which is running on another port. So now we use Nginx to solve this problem. It will take in requests from port 80 and serve whatever it is running on the port which you want. You just need to install Nginx by typing the sudo apt install Nginx, and then it will tell you it will take in 7891 KB of storage. It might increase or decrease in the future, so just press in Y. Now it will download it for you. Just clear out the terminal, and now what you can do is just go to your IP address in the browser. So nothing would happen. Now, why nothing is happening? Because we want to open the ports. Now to view it in the browser, you need to go back to your console and go to security groups, and there just select the default one, go to outbound rules, and click on edit outbound rules. Select the type to be as all traffic and destination as custom at 0.0 and this type, and the safety rules. So now go back to EC2 and then go to network interfaces and select your server which you are currently working on. So the one which I'm working now is this one. So you need to just go to the security groups and just right click there, change security groups. And there you need to select in, you have to search in for default and add this security group and just click on save. So now if we go back here and press F5, it will render this kind of a thing. So now we are almost done with our work. So the thing, what we are seeing here is the one on this part. So that to see the files which are being rendered, you need to go to cd /var/www/html. Now in here, whatever files would be there would be rendered on this page. So to connect to our server, to transfer files to our server, we are gonna use a service known as CyberDuck. So just go to CyberDuck download. The first link which you will see, just click on that and download it for the respective operating systems which you want. So now just go to CyberDuck. If you have downloaded it, just search for CyberDuck and it will be installed on your computer. And there it is open. So it is open here. Now what we need to do is we need to go click open connection, and this should be SFTP, that means SSH file transfer protocol, and the server should be the IP address of your server. Username should be Ubuntu and the SSH private key should be, we need to choose it from our computer, so just click on choose, and then in your downloads you will get it. So now it is mykeypair.pem, and if you just press connect, it will then connect to our server. As you can see, just press on allow to see it is connected. So now we need to go to slash first of all, and then it is listing the directory /var. So that is var here, /var /www/html. Now first of all, let us delete this. You can delete it like this. Oops, we need to delete it first of all. So just press on delete. It has rejected because I don't know. Let us see why is that, as it rejected. So for that we need to make the Ubuntu the user. So just for that we need to write sudo chown, that means change owner -r, that means recursive Ubuntu, and you have to write a dot which means for this current directory. So now if I just delete it, it will be deleted. So as you can see on my desktop, there's a folder as web portfolio, this one which I want to host. So now what I can do is I can just go inside that and just press Ctrl A and drag that and drop it into my CyberDuck. If you want the same file, I'll provide the link in the description for the file. So now the upload is complete, and now if I just go to the domain and refresh here, So we can see the portfolio website which I made. So this is the website which I made, and now it is successfully hosted on this IP address. But we didn't want an IP address, we want a domain. So now for that, what we need to do is we need to go to our domain manager. For me it is GoDaddy. So just go into GoDaddy or whatever domain manager you have, and in there just go to visit my account, find in your domain and come back again. Okay, so just first of all we need to add a record and host it to @, which means the domain itself, and copy in the IP address. So this is the IP address without HTTPS or HTTP. Just copy it and press save. Now if I go to my domain, which is perfactors.com, it will appear like this. Just wait for a couple of minutes, it will open, and there I can see my website on my domain. Now this is how easy you can upload your website on your domain. But you can see it is still not secure. So now how do we make it secure? Don't worry, I'll tell you. So we will use a service known as Certbot. So Certbot, just go to certbot.eff.org, just click on get Certbot instructions and select the software as Nginx on system Ubuntu 20.0.4. So first of all we need to SSH and install snapd. So how do we install snapd? Just click here and you will go to snapd's website, and in there you can just select your operating system, which is Ubuntu in my case. So Ubuntu, and then you need to install it like this: sudo apt install snapd. Now it is installed snapd. Now we need to install Certbot by typing this command. So just copy this and paste it in your terminal, and now it will be installed instantly. We need to go to cd /etc/nginx/sites available. I just click here, we can see a default. So now to edit that, we will use the vim editor. So provide sudo before. Now just press in I on your keyboard, and there you came into insert mode. So what you need to do is go to the server name and write that perfactors.com or whatever the domain is of you. Now just write the sudo nginx -t. So what will happen is it will tell you the system configuration file is fine or not. So just clear out the terminal and just write the sudo systemctl reload nginx. So now if I just write the sudo certbot -nginx. Okay. So first of all, you have to enter email address. So for me, it is zaidajani2007@gmail.com. Now you need to press Y. Again, Y. So press 1 to select your domain. And now it will install an SSL certificate for your domain. So now if you go back to your domain, if you refresh and press F5, your domain will become secure now. So that's how easy you can upload a website, or you can host your website for free 1 year without any tensions. Thank you very much for watching.